you can, let's just take this star field, I can select all, and I copy it. Then I can switch to the other image, and I paste it in there. I'm just gonna put it under, I have to either unlock this background so I can move these layers around, or I can make a duplicate layer. But I've got this magic wand, and remember the magic wand, if I go contiguous and I just click on that pixel, oops, I'm on the wrong layer. I click on that pixel, then it goes in and finds that edge. It'll say, oh, I see all of the white that you're talking about. If I didn't put it on contiguous, it's gonna find all the white. Make a better example. It would find all the white in the rocks too. And so if, imagine this was sky and there was trees and all that sort of thing. You wanna try to set your tolerance where when you clicked on it, if you were contiguous, it would just select the area that's all together, but it wouldn't get between the leaves of all the other trees. So you have to kind of change this tolerance to say, I like this, but I don't want it to get into the rocks. So I'm going to change the tolerance to a lower number. Still doing it, lower number. Now you see this rock's protected, so maybe in the lower number still. Still, these pixels are very, very similar to these pixels. Let's go down to 11. See, we've almost got it where we're being really selective. Instead of saying, I want this pixel at, we'll call 50, and that tolerance is allowing it to get all the pixels that are 75 and 25, then we're narrowing down that tolerance and saying, I want us to look at the 50s, the 51s, and the 49s. That's what you're doing by lowering that tolerance. So if we went to like 5, there's only a little bit of that creeping in. But this is a good example of how that tolerance works. I'm gonna make it contiguous, and it just made it really easy. Right there, it's never going into the rocks because this white doesn't bridge over to those other whites. I put in a mask. What's gonna happen is when I just add a mask, it adds a mask, but it doesn't come in masking anything. So if you want to add a black mask, you hold down your Alt or your Option key at the same time, and now it'll instantly it'll take that selection and make your mask for you. So in this instance, what we're seeing too is you see this edging on the rocks, and that doesn't look accurate. Double click into your mask area and shift that edge. I can shift it out or in. You see it moving there? I'm gonna shift that edge so it kind of collapses a little bit. I can also feather that edge a little so it's a little softer. And now that white, that little white giveaway, that postage stamp look can go away. You can shift that edge just a little bit. The other thing that would help this image is you've built new art here with two separate images that are really different. Go to the half moon and add the little photo filter and give it an overall blue feel that you introduce, so that now that blue field in the sky and the blue in the rocks, they've got this veil over the whole thing, and it's kind of like putting a coat of varnish on your woodwork. It will really help. The other thing we can do in this world is I'm just going to put a change in density on these rocks with a levels adjustment. I can lift them up or bring them down. But I only want to affect the rocks, right? But the way a layer adjustment layer works, wherever it's positioned, it will affect everything below it. So you have to group these things together. You put these two layers together. Come on. Group them. And then don't allow it to pass through. Just say normal. Now what we've got is a way to affect just what's in that group and not the entire image. You see how that works? That group has got the layer adjustment in it. If we had a pass-through blend, that darkness is going to affect what's at the bottom of the stack. But we're going to say, make it normal.
Yeah, normal's better.
Yeah. So anyway.
And how did you select the rocks?
The
magic wand tool?
Yeah. So I deleted this layer. Let's just turn off this. Go back to the original challenge right here. Magic wand.
Magic wand.
And the tolerance, you can just set on 50 contiguous because you're going to select all of this at one time. See what did happen though? This is contiguous. You see how this kind of creeped in? This, because of this tolerance I had, the 50, this pixel is close enough to these pixels that it encroached. It thinks it's contiguous. So let's select it again at 20.
I see. Because it's white almost. Yeah.
So now it isn't encroaching. It's in, well, actually, it's still kind of ragged.
Kind of.
If we went down 5, I bet we can solve that.
Here we go.
Yeah. Yeah, see, even here, the purist in us all would come in and fix that.
And that's the healing brush?
This actually is just a paintbrush.
Paintbrush.
Yeah. But, yeah, so there we've had it selected. And then on that layer, I add my alt option to go ahead and make the mask kick in.
Add layer mask.
Would it be hard to put like a NASA logo? Or like if you lifted off of Google Images or something?
Yeah.
Or
let's do it.
Houston Rockets or something like that?
Yeah.
We've taken a lot of things out of photos. But
I've done it. I do that all the time. Working with schools, I'll go in and look for their image.
Uh-huh.
And here, particularly under Tools, you can go to and grab a size. I want a nice size image. So here we go. That's a nice big image. I go to it. Back up one. I can save it. No, actually, I'm just saving the website.
Does it save that whole square?
Here we go. Save image as. I think it is. That's a PNG. It's or a, yeah, and it's saving. It's floating it out there with a transparent background. I'm going to put it on my desktop. And go back to Photoshop.
But it's going to just do the meatball, not the whole.
Right. And so I open from my desktop. Now see, it opened in a new tab, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just gonna, and you can see this checkerboard behind it, which is telling you.
Transparent.
It's transparent, yeah. Let me add another layer real quick, and you can see that it's transparent back there.
Transparent.
Is that because it's PNG?
That's because it's PNG,
okay.
Yeah. The PNG preserves the transparency.
What does PNG mean?
You got me. I don't know. I don't know what it really means. But most images, all the other images except the PSD, or maybe a GIF,
Photoshop document,
don't have those ability to be transparent like that. But here I am. I can say select it all, copy it, go to the image, go to the place I want to be,
uh-huh.
Get up here to the top of the stack and just put paste. And now I can.
That's cool.
And you can change the size. You know, my favorite is that free transform, that control T. And that's where you can grab these edges and move them around.
Right.
Hit shift and make it smaller or larger. And then also add this effect for a drop shadow. The drop shadow might give you a, you know, kind of separate it out a little bit. You can see how it's, because it's got this shadow.
It drops shadow.
And it'll separate out a little bit, make it look like it's a little more part of it.
Wow.
See how much that drop shadow does?
Yeah.
That looks awesome.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Google says PNG stands for Portable Network Graphics.
Of course it does. You were talking about when you're working for the county, mm-hmm. and you might need to brand 40 pictures with that same logo.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, here's, I'll show you this little trick, which is really pretty convenient. We've got this image right here, and we love this. And when you're working in a PSD, you have all these layer options. But your client or your family is going to come in and they're going to say, I want to, can you show me the one you showed me earlier? And it's like, ah, where's that one? There's a way with layer comps right here.
Layer comps.
So you, those are
combined?
Yeah, they're combined. They're a list of selections in your layers. Let me show you. Here we are. I'm on layer comps. I make a new one.
Make a new layer.
And I just call it one.
Layer one.
So right now there's layer one. I go back. You can't. My layers went away. Now I'm going to, instead of these rocks, I'm going to have those rocks.
Hmm.
All right, so go back to my layer comps, and I call that two. And now you can see I can cycle between these.
Bless you.
Sorry.
So if I had in the, actually it works better if these were people. But perhaps this is, imagine all of these are people. And it's the first face, the second face, the third face. But that branding is always exactly the same place. And so it makes your stuff look really good. Layer comps, we call this three. So now I can cycle through and they can say, well, show me that third one. And you're not in there hunting trying to say, which layers did I have on? Also, when you have adjustment layers on.
So it saves the layers, okay.
It saves, yeah, it saves all of this work. Save the photo filter.
I see, okay.
Let's turn that off for this next one. And let's turn off the NASA logo.
NASA.